Sergeant Ling.
Detective Whiteman, sorry I was late. I was on break when I got the call.
No worries, no worries.
What happened?
A murder's most foul. We have no idea who did it or where they got away to, but we've got Detective Schlock on the scene. Hopefully he can make sense of this mess.
Detective Schlock?
Yes, he's brilliant. He's the best we've got.
But look at him! He's just looking at it! He's just looking at the cup! Just walking into a wall.
Shush! He's walking!
I have deduced using my powers of deduction. Well, when I entered the residence, I realized that there was no sign of forced entry. Upon entering the crime scene, I realized that the messy interior was not due to a struggle, but the victim's swine-like nature. Now, as for the murder, when the victim entered, they had the purpose of making themselves a cup of oolong tea, however, then realized that they had forgotten to procure the oolong tea the day before, and so instead decided to have a alcoholic beverage. After drinking the alcohol straight from the bottle, might I add, the victim then made themselves some toast and sat here at the table alone. After the contemplation, she leaned back in her chair, which fell, causing her to crack her head nastily on the floor below.
So that killed her?
No. After this, the victim walked over to that cupboard over there. A cupboard that contained a long, single strand of brown hair, which, I might add, is what cemented my theory that I have had from the start.
What is it?
That the victim was in fact the murderer, and that it was this new victim that turned the tables on the so-called origami masked killer. So the victim killed the killer. The murderer got murdered. It's elementary, really, my dear Whiteman. Elementary.
He's done it again, my God! Brilliant! Brilliant, fantastic! I tell you, you can do it, Sergeant Ling! This is why we have Schlock around! What a mastermind! So good! So fantastic, I told you! So good! Amazing! Good show! Jolly good show! Look,